This morning, we're joined by NASA astronaut Kate Rubins, who in less than a month will launch to the International Space Station on her first space flight. Howdy from East Texas, Dr. Rubins. We're so glad to have you. 7 years, that's how long you've been training for this moment. So how do you prepare for this on a personal level? What advice have you been given that's not in a flight manual?
Well, we do talk to other colleagues who have flown in space before quite a bit. And a lot of what they share is the day-to-day, how to just live on the space station, how to do your work efficiently, how to keep things from floating out of control when you reach your hand into a bag. But they also do tell you a little bit about how to prepare for a space flight. And some of the best advice I've gotten is just enjoy every moment of it.
That'll be easy to do, I'm sure. Millions of people will be following your mission. Many East Texans do feel a close connection, even a certain ownership in the space program, especially after the Shuttle Columbia tragedy right here in our backyard. How is manned space flight still relevant for our future?
Yeah, I think it's pretty amazing when you look at the international collaboration that we've been able to put together. And just think about the sheer size of the space station and the fact that humanity has been able to assemble something that's the size of a football field traveling 17,000 miles an hour and orbiting around our planet. For me personally, I think one of the biggest impacts is the research potential that the space station has. We have the opportunity to understand how humans can live and work in microgravity, but we also have the opportunity to understand a lot of research questions that have a direct impact here on Earth. For example, diseases like osteoporosis, muscle wasting, and understanding basic biology and cellular behavior, as well as physics and material science.
A laboratory on orbit. Well, here in East Texas, we have the Remembering Columbia Museum, which hosts school kids to excite them about the STEM subjects. What advice would you give to any students doubting they can make it from space camp to space station?
That's a great question. And I think, first of all, the students should never doubt. You know, they should always have that hope alive that they are going to do what they want to do in their chosen career. I think my biggest piece of advice for the students is that they should pick something they're incredibly passionate about. You have to be able to wake up every single morning and get out of bed and say, I'm doing this not as a job, but I'm doing this because I love it and I think it's fascinating and this is how I want to contribute to the world. And if that's your overreaching career advice, wherever you end up settling is going to be a wonderful and an exciting place to be.
Yeah, it sounds like it takes passion. Well, 4 months is a long time to be away from family and friends, but I understand you actually get to take a personal kit with some special goodies. Can you tell us some of the must-have items that you're packing, some things you can't go without?
Yeah, I think for everybody, family pictures, photos from home, that definitely takes up a lot of the space. And, you know, a few small things just to remember your friends and family. You're pretty far away from them, and you are orbiting the Earth at all times. So just having those photos kind of keeps it close to your heart.
I bet. Well, it seems the focus has been on Mars. Coming off the year in space mission, how will Expeditions 48 and 49 get us closer to visiting the Red Planet?
Yeah, we actually have an incredibly complex scientific research program. We have over 200 experiments, and a lot of those are answering questions about diseases or issues that we face on Earth. A lot of times when we're answering those questions about what's going on in a pathologic process on Earth, we're also getting information about how we're going to get to Mars. And so we're building a lot of the fundamental building blocks of how we send human beings beyond low Earth orbit with our expedition and all of our future expeditions. So one thing, as a specific example, on our mission, we're flying a biomolecule sequencer. So we are going to try to do DNA sequencing. And this is the kind of instrumentation that you would want to send on a Mars mission if we're going to be looking for signs of life on another planet.
All right, with eyes focused on the heavens and on the future, Dr. Kate Rubins, you've got a lot of folks back in the States wishing you a safe and successful mission. Thanks for being with us, and Godspeed.